Hey everyone, this is your quick Christian history guy, Jeff Kenny, with my friend Orion here, with another installment of the Christian origins of nearly everything. Part of our video output here is in the area of myth busting, and this video is pretty closely related to that, but not quite. That's for another set of videos. But what do I mean? Well, if you or someone you know has or is or will be donning the familiar cap and gown of academia, as most of us have, at least in the realm of high school, if not college, you may have been encouraged to be thankful that you live in a time when quality education is available to so many, freeing us from the past history of anti-intellectual, superstitious tomfoolery of religion. Religion in general, and possibly Christianity specifically. After all, we all know that the Western world was at its dumbest during those terrible so-called Dark Ages, also known as the Middle Ages, before the Renaissance and Enlightenment finally began a gradual process of moving us further and further into a utopia of educated, happy people such as we live in today, right? Well, wrong on almost every count. And while we dive into the broader topic of the Christian origins of the university system in another video, which you can find by clicking, it's enough to say this time around that Christians actually invented the university system, and they did it during those terrible Dark Ages. Yes, it turns out that by the 13th century, these institutions, unknown even at the height of the classical Greco-Roman world, that is, universities, were sprouting up across Europe as the increased population of cities meant a higher demand for more clergy. That meant more centers needed to train said clergy, and cathedral schools, the precursors of the universities which would follow, filled that need. The scholars studying these institutions took on the attire or clothing of whichever religious order they were entering, which meant hoods and gowns. Actually, a welcome bit of attire in the chilly stone buildings in which they studied. In fact, even in American universities into the 19th century, students wore their gowns as a required part of their daily wardrobe throughout the academic term, carrying on the old Catholic university tradition. Scholars believe the familiar square cap or mortarboard worn for centuries by academics up to today are evolved from the beretta, the square cap worn by Catholic clergy. Again, there's a great deal more to be said about the church inventing the university system, so check out that info in another of our videos. And don't forget to check out all our videos and hit the subscribe button, give us a share on the social media platform of your choice, and keep watching the Christian origins of nearly everything with Jeff Kenny, your quick Christian history guy, and my friend, Orion.